Applying this void rate to particular Tamil Nadu. Tamil Nadu, they are applying void rate to the schools, various schools. What is the status of that? That is void rate.
That is in shell.
It is not sold.
It is supplied.
Sir, if it is in shell.
They are giving free.
Sir, we have to, egg, sir, egg in shell is exempt. Egg without shell, what will be egg without shell? There can be, it can be in the form of powder, it can be in the form of liquid, or it can be, after processing also, remove the shell and then give it there. There can be a question as to whether that will be covered by this egg with, without shell.
What happens when the, if a trader is buying some broilers and processing and selling, processing and this?
He himself process or?
Trader,
I am a trader. He himself
processed.
It will be fresh and this thing. Fresh, fresh or chilled. If it chills it, then if it is fresh without chilling, then it will be.
The definition of eggs, as you said, process it and pack it and sell, will come under GST.
No. I'm sorry. There are two things, sir. One is sale of goods. And other is services.
Service, supply of service.
If whatever on output side, yeah, either you are selling a chicken or you are selling an egg or you are selling a powder or you are selling something in some packet, whatever. For that we need to see the schedule of the goods. There will be some area where there will be exemption, there will not be any exemption. As we said, the chilled and the fresh chicken, there is no tax. Eggs, no tax. Wild eggs also in a shell, no tax. Okay, so long as the activity will fit into here, there will not be any tax. But the minute you sell chicken in a frozen form, in a unit container having a brand name, those activity will become taxable. So, but
that goods, no sir, that they packed and having bearing a brand name, that meat will attract tax. That will attract tax. Now we are coming to the service question.
For that, if you engage somebody, you don't have a facility of doing on your own, you are only a brand name holder, you ask somebody that you can you do this work for me at a mass scale. Whether that activity can said to be a activity in relation to agricultural operation or not? The answer is no. Because it is after the primary form in which you have received it.
That process goes beyond the normal process a cultivator or producer will undertake to market his product.
Yes,
Toll processing.
Now chicken also they are processing some toll processing. They get the bird, they process it, and they charge something and they on that basis they give the process.
The toll processor is basically a job worker, no? I gave him 1 day old chick. Okay, they take it in their poultry farm. And in 45 days or some 50 days the chick become chick is ready for chicken. So they basically hold that chick for 45 days and they feed it.
I'm talking about toll processor of frozen chicken.
Okay.
Processed chicken. Oh, what is that processed chicken, sir?
It is the broiler chicken, the live bird is given to the processing plant. They will kill it, they will do the, all the cleaning work, they will chill the bird and they will give to the that particular farm.
Okay. That is a.
Fresh chicken.
It is a normal poultry output of a cultivator or poultry person. That's a normal listing to sell a check either by live or after killing and then cleaning. Then it should be covered under the agriculture listing. It should be covered.
There is a packing.
Sir, that's what, kindly see the this thing, that such process is done as is usually done by a cultivator or processor? You tell us, because I don't know this industry. Therefore, whether it is normally done by a cultivator to pack and then give, process, pack and then give. If that is the case, then okay. But if it, in a case of paddy, sir, they may give it in a form of paddy. They will not remove the husk and then give. That may not be. Paddy, they agricultural produce, they will give as such only. After if it is processed and then given, it is a different this thing. That activity takes it out of this. Therefore, that process will not be covered by the he is not into agricultural service, because his output is not agricultural produce. So that is the definition, sir. This means produce out of cultivation of plant and rearing of a live animal for food, fiber.
If it is a meat, if we are selling the meat, it is a single ingredient, so it is an agricultural produce, it will not act ask for the taxes. So that if it is a chicken, then if we are giving the live chicken and getting it converted to the chilled chicken, so it is a single ingredient.
No addition
of any salt or anything.
No, that is not processed. But whether it is normally done or that, maybe poultry is covered under this, because rearing of this thing for food. That food is, as such it is given in live, or it may be after killing it and then cleaning and then giving. That may be covered under that. But packing and all that is the one which is slightly going beyond this thing. Normally cultivator, whether they will do, that is the...
Even the meat is also packed, but it is a single ingredient, single agriculture. So here it is also chicken, is also a process, and it is a single ingredient.
What will happen in case of dal? I chane kharidta hu, and I give it to somebody, wo uski dal bana ke de deta hai.
Correct.
So, are you saying that dal is also agricultural produce?
So,
dal
is agricultural produce.
Soybean is the agricultural produce.
Absolutely.
It's still 5% tax.
This definition is for the
services
relating to agricultural produce. Therefore, let us be clear about that. The product coming out of that may be taxable or may be exempt. But the service in relation to that, is exempt. Service in relation to
agricultural produce per se.
Some of the agriculture produce are taxable, some are not. Some are taxable, some are not. But the services in connection with that, somebody may be doing cleaning, somebody may be
warehousing,
doing polishing, warehousing, transformation. Some are exempt. Some are not exempt.
Sir, they have given only around 8 specific services relating to agriculture, apart from transportation service. These are the two. Eight services in one serial number, and another one is transportation service relating to agriculture produce.
Dal, I need to see that. Dal, it must be chapter 7 in the law. So is it tax at 5%? I need to see the schedule.
Sir, Tata Chemical also sells dal. ITC sells
dal. This is soybean pe 5%.
Correct.
Dal pe hai CSV.
I don't think sir. Dal mein hai. You say check.
Second check karke bata rahe
hain. Sir, I just want to clarify now that on what basis.
Sir, branded, though it will be taxable. Sir, if it is put up in a container and then having a brand name, it will be taxed. That is how they have proceeded.
No, sir, soybean is not put in a container.
Soybean is not taxed. Check. Check.
some of the agriculture produce, there is no GST.
Yes.
Am I right?
Yes.
Now I am saying that on what basis is this decided that a particular agriculture produce will be GST applicable and another is not applicable?
Most of the agriculture produce where there is a tax, they said if it is packed in a unit container having a brand name, then those are taxable. See, I will tell you.
Sir, in VAT there was no tax earlier. But now in GST, this concept of putting it in unit container and bearing a brand name was introduced because the big people, they are exploiting this thing, and therefore they wanted to charge this. Therefore, first time it was. Otherwise, earlier there was no VAT on it also.
I agree. Now I'm saying, soybean, for example, is transported in trucks, not in bag. For solvent extraction. Then what is the concept? I'm just trying to clear.
We'll come back. Let me just see the schedule. Instead of making some guess.
You understood the confusion, sir?
I got it. Should not be taxable.
Bharat, explanation here.